हेलो कोडर्स, वेलकम बैक। एज द टाइटल ऑफ दिस वीडियो सजेस्ट, वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस कस्टम एनोटेशन। वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड द कस्टम एनोटेशन इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो। वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट मार्कर एनोटेशन एंड इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द सेकेंड टाइप ऑफ एनोटेशन कॉल्ड एज सिंगल वैल्यू एनोटेशन। We also have multi-value annotation. So single value or single member annotation is a kind of annotation which will have one member, and that member is going to be called as value. So the member name is already predefined. It has to be value. It can have a default value also. Means if you do not supply any value to this annotation, then the default value will be available to that annotation. So this is the way we can use the annotation. ART interface, obviously we must use this format for creating your annotation or custom annotation. Here you can see the value is the member is already predefined, the name is already predefined, it has to be a value. Then to parenthesis you have to supply without any parameter. Then data type can be anything, like it can be a string, it can be a primitive type, it can be a class, it can be enum, it can be also array of those things. And as I said, that single value or single member annotation can have a default value also. So here in this example, this test single annotation is going to have default value as 1 if no value will be supplied. So let us have a look at a complete example with the help of this STS. So if you look at this STS example, this is just the same example which I had used in the previous video. This is just an extension of that same example. So here I have created this vaccinated annotation which has this value as its member, and its default value is 0, and it is retention policy is runtime so that it can be available to the Java runtime environment. And this vaccinated annotation has been supplied to this visa application method, and in this visa application method, just a simple logic, it's going to print a line as visa granted, nothing great. So this second method is also there in this US embassy class. Second method is going to throw no such method exception, security exception, because we are using this reflection process. Here I have gone for finding that method which is named as visa application, and from that method I have got the vaccinated annotation also. And what is the value of that annotation? I have gone for finding that value also and store the return value in a variable called as doge. So if it is 2, means the value of doge is 2, then it is going to call this visa application, and obviously it is going to print the visa granted line into the output screen. If it is 1, then it is going to print another line, visa rejected, go and complete vaccine. If it is neither 2 nor 1, then it is going to print another line of output, visa rejected for not vaccinated, and as well as it is going to print the value of that doge variable. And in the main method, I have gone for creating the object of US embassy and gone for calling that get visa method. Once we call this get visa method, then it is going to play this logic and call this visa application if all this logic satisfies, means if it is 2, then it is going to call this visa application. Let us see. So here one important thing I want to specify: we have not supplied any value to this single value annotation. That means the default value is going to be available. Let us see what is going to happen. If I run it, then you can see it line comes from this else part, visa rejected for not vaccinated, and the value of doge is 0. I have not supplied any value, but I am getting over here 0. If it is non-zero, then what will happen? Now we have to supply the value. Suppose I will say 2. Then what will happen? If I rerun it, then here you can see the visa granted line came because this visa application method got called because of this value of dose is 2. If it is 1, then obviously another line will come. If I rerun it again, then you can see visa rejected, go and complete vaccination because the value of dose is 1. So this is how we can go for using this single value annotation or single member annotation. I hope you have got the requirement of this single value annotation. In the next video, we will discuss about multi-value annotation. Thanks for watching.